So, on a more serious note over the math scandals and Gladys, it is of great sadness that Vygotsky has passed away from tuberculosis. Only 37 years of age, as well as a significant psychological genius for the development of the human mind. Vygotsky composed research that enabled the understanding of a wide cultural variation in cognitive skills, as well as claiming the greater knowledge development occurs from children being assisted and prompted with their learning. I know personally that I would not be here doing what I am today without support from others. How about you, Semi?
Oh, definitely. I wouldn't have a clue at how to train seals without the help of someone who had done it before me. Teaching them to do tricks and all sorts of things really does, it really is a challenge, and might I just add, it's a great honor to be here.
Thanks, Semi. It's really nice to have you here too. So he categorized this assisted learning as zone proximal development, which is where a child can no longer learn by themselves, but rather needs assistance provided by someone who already has those skills, like a teacher or a parent. A unique component to the zone proximal development stage is that of make-believe play. Children are able to imagine different things happening with their own world and act upon these internal ideas, along with learn the skills to think before you act. It's really interesting that as children we learn these skills without even noticing. I am personally very glad that I think before I speak, as there are so many things that run across my mind that should not be said. He also studied the social origins of cognitive development. There are three different features that promote social and cognitive development, and they are intersubjectivity, where two participants begin a task with different understandings but finish with the same understanding, scaffolding, which is adjusting support to match each individual's abilities, as well as guided participation, where the influence of social and cultural practices combine to give support and direction to children. It is a shame that Vygotsky pursued teaching before psychology, along with passing at the young age of 37, as his theory would have been far more developed and probably extremely interesting to learn, not that it isn't already. Anyway, that's enough of Vygotsky. Enjoy the next half an hour of ad-free music without me interrupting you for your morning tea at work today. See ya!